Hello to our fans online. I'm Diana Perez.
And I'm Rob Nelson, filling in the day with some top stories on this Friday, July 12th.
The six jurors in the George Zimmerman trial are getting ready to pass judgment on the former neighborhood watch captain. They'll hear closing arguments from the defense this morning and are expected to begin deliberating behind closed doors this afternoon. Yesterday, prosecutors argued that Zimmerman made bad assumptions about Trayvon Martin and lied about what really happened during their deadly confrontation.
Some survivors of Asiana Flight 214 revisited the scene of last weekend's deadly crash. Most said that reliving the experience with one another helped them come to terms with their terrifying ordeal. Meantime, investigators say they have found no evidence of mechanical or electrical failure in the plane. Their focus will now zero in on what the pilots did in those chaotic seconds before impact.
Two Pennsylvania teenagers are the toast of their town after chasing down a kidnapper and rescuing a five-year-old girl. Police in Lancaster say that the girl was playing in front of her house when a man drove up, snatched her, and then drove off. Well, two neighborhood boys spotted that car, tailed it on their bikes for about 15 minutes, and once the car was stopped, they got the little girl to jump out into their arms, and now she's safely back with her family, thanks to them.
Amen. And a fun fishing trip turned into a nightmare for a family after their boat capsized in a storm off the coast of Maryland. John Riggs was tossed into the water along with his dad, sister, 9-year-old niece, and three-year-old nephew. He left everyone clinging to the boat to get help. Riggs swam for 5 hours battling rough tides, rain, high winds. He was so exhausted by the time he reached the shore that he simply couldn't even walk anymore, so he crawled to the nearest house. By the time they were rescued, the family had been in that jellyfish-infested water for 8 hours. Amazingly, no one suffered any significant injuries.
Amazing. By the way, he said he said a little prayer and finally felt sand under his feet.
Wow.
After swimming all that time.
Two happy endings in that news block. Good to see that sometime. You can get more news anytime at abcnews.com. I'm Rob Nelson.
And I'm Diana Perez. Thanks for watching.
This is World News Now, available anytime, anywhere you want it.
More Americans choose ABC News to see the whole picture.